Good afternoon. Welcome to GrainTV. It's June 16th, 2014. To my right here is Cody Bills to help break down a negative day for the grains in Chicago. You can see we had corn down 6 cents, soybeans moving 4 cents lower for July. Chicago wheat was down 5. Big report here after the close, Cody, was the crop progress numbers. What did we see out of that report today?
Well, first of all, corn's 100% planted here. We do see soybeans 92% complete, but really the focus is shift over toward emergence and crop conditions. Right. Corn came out emerging 97% here this week compared to 92% last week. Corn conditions were very positive, up 1% to 76%, good to excellent. Soybeans emerged, we are around 83% now, and conditions here at 73, down 1% from last week, but still great overall.
You know, here in the Grain Hedge office, we continue to hear from producers really across the grain belt that the conditions that they're seeing right now for this corn crop in particular are better, are well better than what we saw the last couple of years, and even in some cases going back a couple of decades. Take a look at this chart here. This details good to excellent rating across the U.S. By week of the growing season, broken down by growing year here. As you can see here, with 76% now good to excellent, better than what we've seen out of the last 3 years, and an excellent start to the growing season. Obviously, now the question is, what is this going to do to December 14 corn futures? From the production side, things are looking very good, in terms of production. Things are not looking so good in terms of price, and I think there are some lingering concerns right now about demand as well. Obviously, the Chinese import ban is hanging over this market, and today we heard trade chatter that they're going to be looking to sell an additional 30 million bushels from state reserves. So that's obviously not a good story from the demand side of the equation here. And as you can see from the December 14 corn chart, we're now testing some very important price levels right around 440. Keep an eye here on this 440 price level. This is what we tested back in January, and then on Wednesday and Thursday of last week. Wouldn't be surprised if we can see a little bit of follow through selling into the overnight session based on the numbers that we saw today from the USDA.
That sounds fair enough. Now, of course, we also had NOPA crush numbers here today, and they came out ahead of analyst expectations, actually booking 128.82 million bushels for the month of May. That's 2 million bushels over where analysts were expecting. What's interesting is that we ended up closing down on the day. You know, yesterday, it's interesting because on Friday, we had a little bit of a bounce here after selling off pretty hard for the last 2 days. Friday, we had a little bounce. We closed positive. Today, we opened higher. We were trading higher into this report. And when these NOPA numbers came out, we ended up trading lower, closing lower. Now, I think what we're seeing here is a little bit of the buy the rumor, sell the fact sort of thing, as well as kind of a bouncing off of a 50-day moving average or a 50-period moving average. I think the bottom line here is that what we're seeing is technical weakness. What we're seeing is the trade reacting very funny to positive news here, particularly when you look at old crop stocks in the last WASDE report, when you're looking at these NOPA crush numbers. The trade is starting to react negatively to positive news, and when that happens, I get a little bit nervous here. I'm not saying necessarily that we're going to start selling off huge, because we do still have very tight old ending stocks, but the bottom line here is I'm not very bullish here, this soybean crop, just because the trade is reacting very negative to positive information.
Yeah, absolutely. One thing that traders are going to be looking at this week in particular, once again for soybeans, is going to be export sales on Thursday. We once again had good export inspections this week reported by the USDA this morning. And as you said, Cody, just another positive piece of news that really did very little to support prices there on the old crop. As I said, we'll help keep you posted on export sales coming into Thursday's report. That's kind of a wrap up of what we saw here on a Monday for the grain market. Thanks a lot for joining us on Grain TV. We'll see you tomorrow.